What's up, YouTube? Before we get into this game, I want to take a look at my team. And if you guys like these gameplay videos, want to see my team, and have any suggestions to improve my team, please comment below. But this is the team I'm putting in the weekend league right now. So if you haven't seen all the games, you can watch them live. That link is below. All the offense, defense, special teams, MaddenTurf.com link is below as well. This is the team, obviously, with the new golden tickets out. Golden Ticket Vic is my quarterback. As far as I'm concerned, golden tickets are cool. The program is tough. But the only reason you want one is to have four different abilities on a player. And because other 99s can get that, I would be the first to tell you there's no card worth 5 million coins. None. I don't care who it is. Michael Vick, and who else we got? We got the Eagles O-line. We have a little bit of an Eagles theme. Not an Eagles theme team. I feel like if you have a theme team, everybody on your team should be from that team. Pretty much how I feel. But I have 28 Eagles, so we get a point of speed for every Eagles player. That'd give Vic's already 99 speed. But I use Westbrook. As you see, we got Miles Sanders, LeSean McCoy. LeSean McCoy, I put him in fullback. Why? Because everybody pooch kicks. I mean, you guys probably have, like, Christian Okoye, who has a 90-plus speed, whatever it is, there. But I just put McCoy there. Don't even ask me why. Sometimes he gets the ball, but he's, like, ridiculously slow. But I still like him there. He's one of my favorite players ever. We have Calvin. We have Moss. We have Torrey Holt, T.O., Tyreek Hill. Another thing with golden ticket wide receivers, Torrey Holt is a golden ticket pretty much. I mean, you got to realize that he's 99 everything and can get four abilities. Calvin is a golden ticket pretty much as well too. I mean, he just doesn't get the four abilities. But and I'll show you guys who I'm running as my abilities. I got obviously Vic. We'll see what we have, what we actually are running with Vic right now. We are running Bazooka, obviously. I think those abilities, the X factors, are corny. I don't know which one is good, which one you guys like, but Bazooka's best. You throw the ball further. I'm actually running Gunslinger. I know a lot of people like Hot Route Master, but I feel like with two wide receiver chems, getting those hot routes, you don't need everybody to be able to have more hot routes on the field. So I use Gunslinger. I'm not even going to tell you I'm a big fan of that. So if you like Hot Route Master, use it. For me personally, I think this whole crock of abilities are bad. I wish I could have human joystick, or I wish I could have roaming Deadeye in this slot, but I'll use Gunslinger. I think it's my best. Identifier is also a really good perk. I don't really even use it, but it is really good if you guys want to use that. But I'm using Gunslinger, Escape Artist, Quarterback Playmaker, which is just a nightmare to deal with a mobile quarterback, and roaming Deadeye. A lot of people ask about roaming Deadeye and dashing Deadeye. For me, there is no difference. I don't know. I'm not going to tell you roaming's better or anything. The only thing was, and Vic never had dashing that. I always used him. I never got used to sprinting during every pass. Roaming, I got used to letting go of turbo and then throwing the ball. So I just got used to roaming because that's all Vic had. So I'm not going to tell you it's the best. It's better than dashing. I don't know, but I have no problems with it. Every ball I throw is 100% on the money. So for me, I don't see why I go to dashing. If it was not a salary cap thing. If it's mutt, do you use roaming? That's what I'm used to. That's what I'm used to using, and it works well for me. So that's all. Obviously, I have no fast break here, no human joystick here. I think ultimately on mutt, the way I play blast is just not that effective on mutt because so many people hit stick, and a quarterback fumbles 1,000 times more on all pro than all Madden. So I think to win games the most, I would get rid of blast. Blast is fun to run. But I wanted to try quarterback playmaker and roaming and be the best passer I could be this game. So that's what you'll see. And then, like, because I have quarterback playmaker, Torrey Holt doesn't need the playmaker cam, even though he gets it. But what do I run on Calvin? What we run on Calvin? We're going to run double me, obviously. I don't use Moss. I think that ability sucks. I think double me sucks. And we will see that in this game. But streak specialist, post flag elite is the best ability you can have on a wide receiver. And slot apprentice. That's what I mean about not having hot route mass on the quarterback. I just put slot apprentice on Calvin, put him in the slot sometimes. To be honest with you, I don't even really use it that often. But I have it. And the last one I'm going to run is Torrey Holt. Torrey Holt, I believe, has... I said, yeah, Slot-O-Matic. Slot-O-Matic's a glitch in this game. Any times he's in the slot, any little baby route under 10 yards, it is an automatic catch every time they put their hands on it. No matter what, who's around him, automatic catch. Post flag elite, once again, corner route, post route, automatic catch. Automatic. Route apprentice can get any route in the game at any position. That's why I like him. You put a deep post anywhere on the field. It's awesome. Grab and go. Like I said, I have playmaker on my quarterback, so I don't need it on my wide receivers. Now, grab and go. I want to say I wasn't even equipped during this game, but that's what I got running now. Grab and go. I love it because you can catch a drag and just get right up field. It's a great ability if you guys aren't using it. So that's what I'm running on offense. No running back abilities. No, just My wide receiver is Michael Vick's best player in the game for me. Defense, I actually pulled Golden Ticket Polamalu, but I sold him instantly. I did get the new Pat Pete, and I'm actually running him now with an ability, which I would never do in a serious game, run a corner with an ability. But I have Tillman, I have Taylor Mays, Brian Dawkins, Sean Taylor. Those are all my options as safety. I have a lot of options as safety. They can play linebacker, they can play corner, they can play safety. You know, but for me, Taylor Mays is probably the best. I have Tillman because he's a 99, can get four abilities. If you can get four abilities, I feel like you can play over anybody now. That's why I use Night Train. I have Night Train activated. Can get four abilities, including Enforcer. Can also play safety. So, in a perfect world, Night Train would play safety for me along with another safety. But because I have Pat Pete activated, going to put him out and see what he does. My favorite player in the game, so got to activate him, see what he gets going. I have Myles Garrett now at D-tackle. I used Aaron Donald so long, I thought Aaron Donald was the best. I got this new Myles Garrett. Let's take a look at this new Myles Garrett. For me, 91 speed and 97 acceleration and 98 strength. Look, he's just unreal. 99, so he gets four abilities. That's pretty much what the game is right now. You want your abilities, your guys to have four abilities. You know, Myles Garrett is there. I had the new Von Miller. As far as I'm concerned, the draft promo was a W. I got Patrick Peterson, Von Miller, Myles Garrett, all for probably around 500K, 600K. The day it came out, it's probably even cheaper now. So you get three really good cards for cheap while people are spending so much money for golden tickets. Golden tickets are cute fun, but I mean, if Myles Garrett gets four abilities, he's pretty much a golden ticket at this point of the game. You probably already have 99 speed everywhere. That's what I have. Darius Slay, big play Slay, the newest Eagle. Got to have him out there. Lattimore and Deion. Deion's glitched. I mean, I don't care what card comes out. Deion still needs to be somewhere on the field. But that's it. I love Deion Jones. People talk about linebackers and players for me that you know, play a lot. Deion Jones, I love Deion Jones. I think he's a dog. I think he's the best middle linebacker in the game. I really do. And Patrick Willis will never be outdated. Clowney, I believe this is – I have the full Clowney, but I believe for salary cap he got bumped down a little bit. Anthony Barr, I have him too. So I got four players from the draft thing. Really popping. I love that that promo worked out great. So that's my defense. So let's get into some gameplay. This was a weekend league game. I want to say my 10th game of weekend league. Definitely undefeated before this. I feel like once I lose a game of weekend league, I just don't want to play anymore. The goal is to always go undefeated. And if you want to watch these games live, twitch.tv/dub. That link is below. First play of the game, we got to go up and try to hit them. You got to see what the back end of their defense is looking like first play of the game. That's what I always say. Then we see that quarterback playmaker that I talked about in the earlier part of this video, that quarterback playmaker hitting Holt right there. This is one of my first games using it as I throw the corner route right there to Torrey Holt. That's that roaming deadeye I talked about rolling the wrong way. He did fumble and put it on the ground, but that's cool. We'll be all right. This was one of my first games using it. Right here, you see it kind of got me picked off. And that's cool, but I got to get used to – I mean, playmaker's great, but you got to realize you got to have the route concept so you can't get crazy lurked like that. Like, I kind of playmakered him right into a spot where he could cover that and the corner route, and Barry Sanders just disrespected that Night Train lane I talked about. But Pat Pete, best corner in the game, hustling down to stop the touchdown. That's what it's about. And Jadeveon Clowney coming off that edge. If you don't have Jadeveon Clowney, he is probably the number one must-have card in Mutt. I mean, no matter what quarterback, running back we have, Jadeveon Clowney is probably a must for everybody's team. Get to a third and goal. He tries to hit the tight end delay out the backfield. Who's there? Clowney. Hold him to a field goal. So remember that. We see Pat Pete hawking him down, chasing him, making a play on the ball. That's what Pat Pete does. Just pure hustle. And, you know, we get scum kicked to the 7-yard line here. Once again, just not really loving this play that much, or this setup with the playmaker that much. But we get out from the back of the end zone. This time we're going to go ahead and try to roll to the right. And we do. Playmaker again, and we get picked off again on the playmaker. So right now, playmaker and drags up into corner routes is not the way I want to use the playmaker, Kim. It's kind of getting me killed. And right there, he's pissed off because his lineman just tackled Barry Sanders on a would-be touchdown. Once again, we're going to hold the door. A lot of bodies around the football. That's the only way to tackle these Barry Sanders. Goes for RPO. Big play Slay is not having that. Any RPO set, we definitely shade down. Befriending the bots, I talked about shading down. And that's what we did right there. Made sure we're getting hit with an RPO. We pitch it back to Pat Pete. Can we make a play? Nothing. But right now, I'm going to be honest, I'm just chucking the ball. Just trying to find plays with this playmaker. And it's getting me popped. And one thing about 3-4 Bear... 3-4 Bears, it's a good pressure defense. It brings a lot of pressure. The biggest weakness of the 3-4 Bears, we throw underneath here to T.O. Get a block from Miles Sanders and get out of bounds. Manageable fourth down. The one thing about 3-4 Bear, if you're not going to blitz eight people, it's just impossible for 3-4 Bear to cover spread out formations. You'll see. I don't know if I even go back to that that tight the rest of this game. I pretty much spread them out, make them just destroy these zones. There's a single high safety, so therefore it can't really be cover two. If your outside corner is probably pretty much always in a deep blue, as we find another dot over there to Randy Moss. So when I see that 3-4 Bear, really like to spread it out with some type of trips or some type of, you know, spread, anything to really put stress on the coverage for the 3-4 Bear. Really don't think it's that versatile at all, as we throw a little hitch right there to Torrey Holt, I believe. Or maybe that's Calvin, one of those 81s that's just a dog. When they touch the ball, they pretty much make plays. They catch it every time. That's pretty much how the catching abilities, with the route abilities work, man. If you're not using two wide receivers, I mean, maybe you could use a running back. Maybe you like a running back. I don't know. For me, these wide receiver abilities are pretty cracked right now in the game. As you see him using a little Torrey Holt playmaker himself. Now, I'm not sure if it's Patrick Mahomes that has playmaker that he has. I believe the best Mahomes does get playmaker, as we actually, Myles Garrett right there forces a throw out of bounds. I'm pretty sure Mahomes does get quarterback playmaker. He has all day right here. I have no quarterback spy, and he's going to go ahead and pick up the first down, I believe, on a 3rd and 14. Just was not ready with my adjustments. You see Myles Garrett getting crazy, making plays, and he throws to that boy Deion Jones. I'm telling you, in zone and coverage, Deion Jones is the best in the game. He almost plays zones better than safeties, better than corners, and stuff of that nature. We see that playmaker there almost brought Calvin right back into Ryan Shazier. I'll tell you, man, they will always catch the ball if they have those abilities. Pulse route over the middle, Randy Moss. We're waiting for his new Ultimate Legend card. Probably the only card I'm really waiting for. Him and Sean Taylor are pretty much the two guys I'm waiting for, as Westbrook drops a pass out of the backfield there. Gets a second down. We're running out of time here as Westbrook catches that just with shit in his pants. Sometimes you catch the ball with shit in your pants. That's what happened right there. 3rd and 9. We're going to throw this drag. Try to get that block from... Ooh, and Shazier killed me. So we're going to take a 3, or we're going to try to pull one under and try to go ahead and get this fake field goal, and Denzel Ward's not having anybody. I believe he was in field goal safe, man. That did not work out. So instead of taking my 3 right there, we went for the fake field goal. Tried to pull a fast one. Didn't work out. But nope, that's why they watch. And if you want to watch, you guys know the Twitch link. As he almost catches a bomb right there on Tillman, but Tillman's not having any of it. So second half, just got to get used to the playmaker. Stop throwing picks right at his user. We'll be all right. That's how I feel. Honestly, the 10th game of weekend league is really shouldn't be this sweaty. But we like it sweaty, man. That's one of the models, man. We like it sweaty. That's why they watch. And we just got to go ahead. I honestly couldn't even tell you what his offense is. We talked about 3-4 Bear. If he's not in 3-4 Bear, he's in an over G look. That's a little deuce close. As we see Myles Garrett, that run stopper ability I have on him and enforcer on him just absolutely killed right there. People say don't put enforcer on D-tackles. I love it because he just got a hit stick right there. As he clicked me on Peppers. Peppers is not the worst person to be clicked on, as I try to make a play on this playmaker right there. And maybe Peppers is the worst person to get clicked on because he did feel slow right there. Just got to tackle Barry Sanders, man. That's pretty much the key when you play these Dickersons, play these Barry Sanders and down to the new bow. And right here, he's going to hit me with a playmaker. I got to cover that. So I leave Tyreek Hill and Night Train runs right by him. Honestly, that's probably bad user on my part. Sometimes you got to realize when you can't catch a pick, and when you can't catch a pick right there, don't think I could have caught the pick. And I went for it anyway. So I kind of got him out of position to make that tackle. So as much as I want to say Night Train sucks and blame the game sucks, I got to have better stick right there. And my user was really bad. But the first play, we're going to touch the Baja. That's where we go. We enjoy the Baja. Going up, post flag elite Calvin Johnson and take it to the Baja. So just like that, we go back taking the lead. Got to kick the ball off to Barry Sanders. That's pretty much what it's going to be, man. Can we stop Barry? Can we put bodies around him? That's what it's about, bodies around the football. Because, you know, these running backs, they're going to break the first tackle right there. You know, just, and you see Dawkins just take that terrible angle at the end there. You can just outflank. When the safety's chasing, you run sideways, dumb shit will happen. You know, if they have Barry, they're going to have Dickerson on the bench. That's how it works, boys. 2-for-1 special. Goes for the little screen right here. Myles Garrett was all over it, right? I'm telling you, Myles Garrett is pretty much a golden ticket. If you can't get them golden tickets, make sure you get enough of these draft promo players to really help you out. Right there, he was going for the post route. I believe Patrick Peterson would have been all over that to stop it, but he's kicking another field goal. I mean, listen, field goals, they look good. You know, they feel comfortable, but they don't win football games. One thing you learn from watching this channel, watching me play, man, the game is about threes and sevens, and I cannot get away from Aaron Donald. Aaron Donald has been a golden ticket for about 2 months now. Honestly, he's a great card. Right here, we do that playmaker again. Vic with a crazy roaming dead eye. Just enough to make this a fourth down manageable. Oh, this is third and six. Not fourth down yet. We want to step up in the pocket like a man. Deliver this curl route over here to Torrey Holt. Of course, he's not dropping it. It's Torrey Holt. He's a golden ticket. Get me to a first down. Now, I notice he's been running this cover three, right? This cover three. So Ed Reed and the safety is in the box, has the deep responsibility. So, and I notice he has a soft squat there. So we're going to try to glitch him out right here. We're going to try to burn that cover three. And somehow I can't. I think that's a bad pass lead, but Ed Reed picks it off. Boom. Actually makes the play. I can't believe he got back to that. Really thought I would have a touchdown right there to Calvin Johnson. Ed Reed gets back with that cover three cloud. But that's all right. We're still down two. This is why they watch. I got to get off the field. Got to make a stop. I'm playing super aggressive right here. Jumped underneath route. Got no pressure. And he hits the corner route up top to Torrey Holt. Boom. That's what you got to do, though, man. You can't let him bleed the whole clock. Got to get the ball back. We're 2 minutes. We're down 9 points. And 9 points means two possessions. So you got to play it. Like, you're going to have to get the ball. To win this game, you have to get the ball back. So every time I can get out of bounds, I need to get out of bounds. That's pretty much the philosophy. Huge play right there. Boom, when we get out of bounds right here. Bang! Stop the clock. A field goal's okay. You know, it's not the worst thing in the world. As I throw this playmaker back across the field, going to try to run out of bounds. Stop the clock. Stop the clock. Boom, the clock is getting super stopped now. We're fine. Now, honestly, I really can't throw anything as I throw this Dragon Leaf. Want that block? I don't get that block. Now, what I want to do here is I'm going to spike the ball. Now, obviously, it's not, I guess, spike it. It's not, you know, it's a dumb thing to do. It's not the last drive of the game, but I want to stop, catch my breath. A lot of times with this, I can't do any hot routes if I no huddle. Even though I wasted down, it's okay because if I don't get this first down, I'm going to kick my field goal anyway. Give me one play. Look for the corner route. Touchdown, but bounces off his face. And that's okay because I saved time by spiking the ball, and I still have the two-minute warning. The most important thing of that drive was get my field goal. As you see the field goal twice, that's the editing skills we have. I get my field goal twice, and I still have the two-minute warning. So I have four timeouts, essentially, to get the ball back. Not just three, I have four. So we're going to kick it deep here. No onside, because onside puts him in field goal range pretty much, especially with these kickers. And I don't remember the last time in my life I've ever got an onside kick. So we're going to just, all we got to do is stop Barry Sanders. Picks up a couple yards there. It's a two-minute warning. We're not going to use our timeout. Next play, he's going to run Barry Sanders again. We have bodies all over him. Garrett, Clowney, and he's going to break it off and go to the end zone. So, even though our clock management was impeccable, everything worked out perfectly for us to get the ball back. We are back down two possessions. Now, big part of this game here, we're going to stop him. Myles Garrett making plays. You see Myles Garrett making plays. We stopped him from getting the two. So, we are down 12 points. Two touchdowns. You know, some people say this is why they watch. I know this is why they watch. So if you guys aren't catching these games live, you're really missing out. Another play, boom, just hit this in route. Get a nice gain right there, nice 20 yards. Got to get out of bounds in this situation. I cannot use my timeouts. I need them on defense. You have to realize, to win this game, I need the ball back. And I need to get out of bounds. He doesn't guard the drag route over here to Gronk. Getting out of bounds, even though it's just 12 yards, it's not a huge chunk, but getting out of bounds is the most important aspect of this drive right now. Go with a playmaker over here to Calvin Johnson inside the 20. We are going to go to the huddle, I believe. Call the same play. Just dagger if you guys haven't been playing Madden this year. I don't need any hot routes on this play. I can just let it go. He's not guarding B, which is a huge mistake. Bang, right there, Calvin Johnson. We score in 30 seconds. Didn't use any of our timeouts. Things feel great. I feel amazing. Just the same thing. Got to get the ball back. Got to stop Barry Sanders. Bodies around the football. That's what it's about. Myles Garrett again. Block shed, hit stick. Run stopper, enforcer. Boom. He's a golden ticket. That right there looks scary, but Von Miller and I believe Deion Jones got there. Third down, Clowney sheds. Clowney around the edge. Boom, there's big play Slay. Fouled up by P. Willie. We force a punt, so we're going to get the ball back. Buckle up. We're going to have about 45 seconds. No timeouts. But the one thing Mutt doesn't have is a runoff. So you really must have all day in the world. There it is, Slide Apprentice. Now I notice, once again, I run up here and spike. And why? Because now I can catch my breath. Now I can do 100 hot routes. Now I can shift these receivers without the clock running. I notice Calvin Johnson got double me. He let him get enough 20-yard completions to have double me. Now, are we going to trust double me for the Chaloops in a game like this? Now, on paper, double me should work if I have a one-on-one. Double me should be money if I have a one-on-one. And here we go. We're going to motion block. We're going to have all day max protect. I have a one-on-one. Lob it up. Calvin Johnson, Deion Sanders swatted away. Double me is absolutely broken. If I could take it off, I would. Get another big play. He runs by the crossing route. Boom. Calvin catches it. Goes out of bounds. Clock stop. Next play. Boom. Same thing. Wait for it. Hit B again. Boom. That's where it's at. Now, 17 seconds. No timeouts. Got to go to the end zone. Step up. He's in cover three. Find the curl route. Boom. Touchdown. Dot. Touchdown. That's what it's about. Just making the right plays. Now, here is interesting because you can almost lose the game on a two-point conversion if you fumbled or pick six, anything. So I kept this safe. Gave it to Westbrook right up the middle. Actually got the two-pointer that he didn't get. So we're up by three. Now, this is a tough situation here at the end. Just got to go ahead and keep him out of field goal range. He has three timeouts, so one big play could do it. Great tackle right there by Anthony Barr on the special teams. First play. I didn't like my defense, so I was going to go offside just to get a new defense, but I left one-on-one with big play Slay. Best corner in the game. Picks it off, but I was offsides. That's okay. It's only 5 yards, and took it down to one play left in the game. Pretty much put everybody in deep blue here. Throws it up one-on-one, Pat Pete. That's not going down, and that's GG's in the chat. I'll tell you guys, man, we got to go over what we actually learned during this game. What we learned this game really is that when you're down two possessions, man, getting one of those possessions is important. And also, man, if there's 2 minutes left, 4 minutes left in the fourth quarter, the clock always stops when you get out of bounds. So obviously it's important to get out of bounds when you're on an under 2 minute drive. But if there's 4 minutes left in the fourth and you're down a lot, still take the time to get out of bounds because it'll help you stop the clock. Also, man, it's okay if you're down two scores to take that field goal early, take that field goal fast. Also, I never onside kick with three timeouts left. Never. Unless for some reason there's 20 seconds left in the game or something. But at that point, I would have used my timeouts anyway. But for me, always kick deep. Always kick deep when you have three timeouts. Use your way to go out the field. Also, if sometimes you got to watch a game and see the results and say, man, what could my opponent do differently? For me, I mean, when you're third down, I need one first down to close out the game and I'm up by a touchdown. I need to, you know, my opponent needs a touchdown. I'm definitely going for it. I'm definitely third down. I'm passing. I'm not going to hand the ball off and just hope I get the first down on a run. I'm going to try to air it out, get the first down. And even think about going for it on fourth down, though. You had a good punt. At the same time, man, when you have an opportunity to take the game, you got to get it. Don't ever let Madden decide your fate. Or don't get the ball in another person's hand and say, maybe I can play defense. Go win the game.